back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jalen. Well, hey, a couple of firsts today. First podcast ever from West Palm Beach, Florida, at least for me. And first time we have a question that's sent in from Afghanistan. This is Morne. Morne is trying to figure out how to highlight all of the records that fall on a weekend. So I would approach this using the weekday function equal weekday. The return type. I can never remember the return type. I know there's three of them, so I'm just going to come up here and type all three of them, 1, 2, and 3, and we'll build a formula here equal weekday. Go grab that date over there in column A using that return type up in row 2. And let's see, we'll copy this down and over. All right, so here's Monday. I want the one that is return type 2 because that's where Monday is a 1, and then it's very nice that the Saturdays and Sundays fall greater than 5, basically 6 or 7. So now to apply that conditional formatting, we'll go to Format, Conditional Formatting, and I'll say I'm going to change it from cell value is to formula is. I'll build a formula here that's going to refer to cell A3. That's the active cell. And so we say equal weekday of $A3, comma 2, greater than 5. And if all of that's true, then we'll choose a format. So we'll click OK, click OK. See, the weekends are highlighted. And then if I change the starting date, so let's put in 12/5 or 12/4/2008. It instantly updates. All right, so that's how I would approach it. Morne actually sent in his own answer, and his is pretty cool too. If we go to Format, Conditional Formatting, didn't use the weekday function, used the text function. Took the text of that date, and think about it, at least in English, we're going to get Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. The weekends start with an S. They're the only days that start with an S. So he just checked to see if the left character is an S. And then that's true, but then if it's not true, he added a second condition out here that says, hey, go look for the date within this range of public holidays, and that also might be true, in which case it's going to return a number greater than 1, that's treated as true. And so the advantage here with Mornay's solution is that it also can highlight the holidays. So here, Christmas and the day after Christmas are highlighted as well. So actually, a fairly cool way to go. So, a couple of different solutions to the problem. The shortcoming with this is if you're using a language other than English, you may not get the same results because your days of the week are going to be spelled differently. Weekday is probably a safer way to go there. I want to thank Mornay for sending that question in, and want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast for Mr. Excel.